Okay.
Let's get going.
Thank you, Keith. And thank you to the organizers for the invitation. It's always great to be here in Trieste, and better if there is a great conference like this. And before I forget, this is a joint work with Carlos Vázquez. It's with this, Vázquez. Ah. From the Catholic University of Valparaíso, Chile. Okay. I will work with diffeomorphisms of the three torus, a partially hyperbolic diffeomorphisms. That means almost everybody knows now, but that the tangent bundle splits into three invariant bundles. And in this case, the three bundles are one-dimensional, and this is a contracted bundle, this is expanding, and the center bundle has an intermediate behavior, okay? And then I will talk about attractors in this setting. The question we have in mind with Carlos is if it is possible to have two attractors with intermingled basins in a robust way, okay? And I will show that in this setting it's impossible to have this. But there are examples. I will show you with this kind of examples. But I will start with a very simple example, that is the following. You take your favorite linear hyperbolic automorphisms of the two torus, 2, 1, 1, 1, something like this, and take this diffeom F that is A times some pole, north pole, south pole of the circle. This is from T2 times S1 to S1. And then you have the following situation. We have the one torus. The other torus, two fixed torus. I have here P that is repelling, and Q that is an attracting point. And then, of course, if the derivative of phi is weak enough, this is a partially hyperbolic diffeomorphism. And it is an action A. You have an attractor, a repeller that are hyperbolic. And you have here this torus, both of them, are saturated by unstable leaves and stable leaves. Okay? But this is not a robust situation. If you think a little bit, in this, for the repeller, if you make a perturbation, almost all perturbation, you can break down this joint integrability between the stable and the unstable, the strong stable and the strong unstable manifold. manifolds. And if you perturb, you will obtain that this, the of course, it's a repeller, then the stable is still in the repeller. It's contained in the repeller. But the unstable one is no longer in the contained in the repeller, and then you will obtain that that this is outside and start to go to the attractor. Okay? This with almost every small perturbation. Then that means that this is a very simple example. You after the perturbation, you still have a torus here that is no longer differentiable, it's only a continuous torus. And why I like this example is because the spirit of the idea behind the talk is that when you have the basin of an attractor, it's very difficult. Of course, the basin of attractors, whatever is the attractor, are saturated by a stable manifold. And then it's difficult to have unstable manifolds in the boundary of the basin of the attractor. This is the philosophy behind this. And then I will give another example, more complicated example that is due to Kang. Yes? That you cannot, it's very difficult. The original example in the when you have the product, you have that in this toroid, in the repeller, you have unstable manifolds. Okay? A strong unstable manifold. This torus is the boundary of the basin of attraction of this one. Okay? But it's this situation is not robust. If you perturb this, you don't have unstable manifolds in the boundary of the basin of attraction of these other torus. Yes. Because you have the this is a product with this. Everybody goes to the south pole. So the torus that is in the south pole. Okay, this is the situation. Yes. Yes. This one. This is not a robust situation. You can perturb and destroy the situation to have unstable manifolds in the boundary of the basin of these torus. You still have here a torus, but that is a repeller, but it doesn't contain any strong unstable manifold. Yeah. See, it varies continuously. Yes. You have the conjugacy. It's an axiom A with this is a hyperbolic set, and then you have a conjugacy with these dynamics. But it is no longer differentiable. You have that this torus, this torus after perturbations will be only continuous or something. Sorry? Continues to be invariant, yes. But for instance, you cannot support here a Gibbs measure because you don't have a U-Gibbs measure because you don't have the unstable, the strong unstable manifold. Huh? This is. Other example. Also, in the product of the two torus times the circle, but this is more complicated. I will take something that is A and some, the phi now depends on the base point. Okay, and I will make some, I will put some hypothesis in this phi. And I will suppose for simplicity that A has two fixed points. It's possible, okay? It has two fixed points. And then I have here the torus. And I have here P and Q. These are P, zero. And here I have P 1/2. That is, and Q 1/2. Okay? The first thing is that on this circle, I will suppose that P is an attracting point, and this is a repeller. And on this circle, we have the, in the other way, this is a repeller, and this is an attractor. Okay? These are North Pole, South Pole diffeomorphisms, but here P is an attractor, and here Q is a repeller, and Q here is an attractor, and P here is a repeller. Okay? And of course, the other condition is that the derivative of phi is small enough to be such a way that this is a partially hyperbolic diffeomorphism. And the other thing is that if you integrate the derivative of phi at zero with respect to the Lebesgue measure here in the torus, this is smaller than zero, and the same for the other torus. You can obtain a family of diffeomorphisms like this with these properties. It's not very difficult. And then I have the following. I have two measures, M0 and 1/2, two measures here that are SRE measures, physical measures, because with this condition, you have that the center Lyapunov exponent is negative for both. And if you take here any stable manifold for this measure, okay, and you iterate it, it is dense in the whole torus. Okay, because you have that the stable manifold of this point is the stable manifold here in the torus times the circle minus this point. This is dense in the torus. And if you take here a basin stable manifold for this measure, it's a two-dimensional manifold, and then you have, since the unstable of this point is dense, it will intersect here, and then you iterate this, and we'll obtain that the orbit of this manifold is dense. And then the basin of attraction of this measure, of this torus, is dense, the whole torus. And the same for the other measure. It's the same argument, with Q instead of phi. Okay? Then both measures have dense basins. Okay? And this is what is called intermingled basins. Okay? And then we want to show that this type of phenomena are not robust, both type.
Eh? Sorry? The only physical measure.
These are, I guess so, I don't know. But, yes, I think that here the union of the basins has full measure in this case. And then let me state our result. Is we have a partially hyperbolic diffeomorphism of the three torus, dynamically coherent. That means that we can integrate the center and with compact center leaves like this. And suppose that you have mu an SRB measure or physical measure, mu physical measure with a negative center exponent, a center. The other two are one positive, the other negative, always. And we have a invariant, of course, compact, invariant saturated set K. Contained where? In the closure of the basin of the measure minus the support of the measure. Like this torus here, the repeller, and in the original example, when you have the product, and like what? This torus for this measure, and this other torus for this measure. Okay, this is the K.
Example.
Yes.
These measures are the measures
on the torus. Yeah.
And the basins have positive volume.
Yes, positive volume, of course, because you have that here is Lebesgue. Then it's SRV, but because the other exponent is negative. The center exponent is negative. The unstable manifolds are the strong unstable manifolds of the diffeo. And you have Lebesgue on the toroid. These are lines of the toroid. Then the measure is SRV.
So it's
Lebesgue. Both are physical measures, yes.
And they are the only two physical measures.
In this case, yes, I don't care, but they are the only, for the result, I don't care if they are the only physical measures, but in this case, they are.
In the field, it would be one of those measures, is that not the exact?
Sorry? Mu is one of these, for instance, this. Yes. Mu, of course, is ergodic.
Ergodic. K is the boundary of the basin of the
touch. Yes. That's the meaning of this. That is in the closure. Because the boundary of the basin here is everything else. But because it's, the basins are dense. But you take a set in the closure of the basin, but that doesn't intersect the the support of the measure that contains all its unstabilities, strong unstabilities.
Is that a U or a mu that you've got?
Here's U and here's mu. let me change here. Okay. And the conclusion is that K contains a torus tangent to ES plus U. Explain this. This is not robust. We have a result with Keith, Federico, Tenhans, Federico, Hannah, Anna Taliskaya, and me, showing that accessibility is open and dense among the partially hyperbolic diffeos with one-dimensional center. Then you cannot have this, something that integrates ES plus U for an open and dense set. Okay? That this is not robust is a corollary of this. And another comment is that, if the diffeo is dynamically coherent in the three torus, is the only case where you can have this kind of situation, like this. Because if you have a partially hyperbolic diffeomorphism in the three torus, or it has, dynamically coherent, or all the center manifolds are circles, compact, or it is semi-conjugated to an anosop diffeomorphism of the three torus. And in this case, you have only one minimal set for the foliation, for the unstable foliation. And then you can have only, this is always U saturated, the support of a physical measure. And then you cannot have other set with disjoint from this, because you have only one minimal set. Okay? Then in the three torus, this answers the problem of the robustness of this kind of phenomenon.
So the negative Yamato exponent is compatible with the compact leaves.
Sorry?
Negative
Yamato. Yes. Yes. It's only to you have this example. It's only to have this, because the measure is ergodic, and then if you have this, you obtain that the Lyapunov exponent is negative. This coincides with this integral is equal to the Lyapunov exponent for this measure. The measure is ergodic, and then you integrate the derivative in the center. Which is not absolutely continuous. Yes, it's absolutely continuous with respect to, if you take the conditional measures, here is the linear one. The conditional measures are Lebesgue. It's the length in the line. And it's physical. Well, this was one. In the three torus, we have also the non-dynamically coherent diffeomorphism. I don't know how to lead with this case. In other manifolds, in the nil manifolds, you have that also there is only one minimal set for the unstable For any partially hyperbolic diffeomorphism in a 3-nil manifold, you have only one minimal set for the unstable foliation, and then again, the result is trivial. You cannot have, you don't have this type of examples. Well, and the proof, and the time I have, let me. The idea is, first, we try to show that the intersection of K, we have K, and you have the intersection of K with a center leaf. K intersects every center leaf because you have the unstable leaves project onto the unstable leaf of the anosov. In the if you take the quotient by the centers, the dynamic is anosov, and the unstable leaves project onto the unstable leaves of this anosov, and then these are dense, and then since K is compact, the projection restricted to K is onto this tutorial. And then that means that K intersects all the center leaf. Every center leaf is intersected. And then you have your intersection of K with the center leaf. And then we show that this intersection is a finite set. And the idea of the proof, this is, in fact, a delicate part, because, of course, if you take if the intersection is infinite, then you will have 3 points that are very close to each other. These 3 points. And then this is the intersection with K. Then you have your unstable manifolds here that are the K unstable manifolds. And then if you take the stable manifolds through these unstable manifolds, you have three small disks here. But this is in the closure of this, okay? And then in the middle, you have a point that is in the basin of the mesh. And the idea is that we have a problem here, because I want to show that the stable manifold of this point intersects one of these sets. It's in the middle, no? You have three, and then. But you cannot take the strong stable manifold, because the strong stable manifold through this point is parallel to this disk. And then you have to show that the center manifold is long and goes to the support of the measure. And this is the hard part. If I have time, then I can tell how to obtain this. Yes, because in general, you may have that the stable manifold is very thin in the center direction. It's very small in the center direction. And this is the problem. We have to show that the center is large. Because if the center is large, you intersect here with the... It's large, and it is contained in the stable manifold of this point. We want this. Okay? This point is in the stable manifold of the... In the basin of the measure, is in the stable manifold of some point of the support We want to show that this center is contained in this stable manifold. And then if you have this intersection, you have a contradiction, because the points that are in this disk are not in the basin of the attractor, because are stable manifolds of points of K that is invariant, and then for the future these points go to K, not to the support of the measure. Okay? And then this is modulo proving this, that the center is long enough, is the way to show that you have a finite number of points. And then if you have a finite number of points, you manage to show that it's not completely trivial, but not difficult to show that the intersection, the number of points that intersect each center, is constant. Okay? And then if you have that this is constant, you will have that this point vary continuously with the center. And then you have something K is a finite number of points on each center that vary continuously with the center. You are covering the two torus, then this is a torus. Okay? You locally will have here a disk at each point when you vary the center with it. And then, well, we have that this is a torus. It is U-saturated, this torus. And I want to show that it is S-saturated. Okay? And then what happens if it is not? If I have part of K, of this torus, here are the unstable manifolds. And suppose that the stable manifold of this point is not contained in this set. Then it leaves the set. Then by continuity, in a neighborhood of this point, you have that all stable manifolds do the same. Okay? Well, very near here. And then you obtain an open set here, a neighborhood of this point, or something close to this point, that is here, where every point has an stable manifold that is this way. Okay? But in this neighborhood, all this stable manifold intersect K. But in this neighborhood, you have points of the basin, because this is in the closure of the basin. And the stable manifold of this point cannot intersect K, because I are in the basin of the measure. And then this situation is impossible. And then you have that these torus contain also the stable manifolds. And then the more technical part for the end. I want to show that the following, that if I have a point X that is in the basin of nu, any, I changed the name of the measure, then that is y in the support. Mm? Oh, sorry. Me. Such that the arc, the center arc, joining x in one center arc, because you have two, the center is a circle. One center arc joining X and Y is contained in the stable manifold or why. Or here, stable in the sense of basin, the two-dimensional manifold. Okay. Not the strong stable. This is impossible for the strong stable. It's for the two-dimensional stable manifold. And then the idea is the following. Of course, we have that x is in the stable manifold of some point. X is in the stable manifold of C with C in the support of the measure. Okay? This is because it's in the basin. And then, of course, I can suppose that C is in some basin block, and you iterate it. And after many iterations, this is an iterate of Z, but I can suppose that X is very near Z. It's iterating for the future. Yeah, but I will take the iterations. This is Fn of Z for some large n, and this is Fn of X. This is here. These are very close. And we have the following. The support of nu of the measure is also U-saturated. Okay? And the intersection of the of a close U-saturated set with the centers has some continuity properties. It's semi-continuous in some sense, because it's closed. And then the limit is contained in the limit. Then you can suppose that very near here, there is a point where this intersection varies in a continuous way. Okay? It's a point of continuity, of this intersection, because the intersection is a semi-continuous function. And then if you are very near W, you have that all points here intersect in the centers. If you take a point here near W, you take that there is a point of the support in the center that is very near this point. Okay? Then the way to show this, roughly speaking, is to take the basin block of the point Z. Okay? You intersect here with a small neighborhood, and then you have here a set of positive measures where the stable manifolds are large because you are in a basin block. Okay? And then you iterate this point, the point, again, the point F and Z, in such a way you go to this neighborhood. And then you obtain that the center is very short and is contained in the stable manifold because the stable manifold is large because you are in a basin block. Then you iterate for the past and obtain the property of having the center inside the stable manifold. Okay? And that's it.